and create political benefit. What I've said is, if you're going to spend the money, at least spend it solving problems. At least make sure you're building better roads. You're getting homeless folks off the street. You're getting them the help they need, that you're getting them behavioral and mental health assistance, that you're making sure that all these things are happening. That's not what the priority of these people are, right? These people are all about one time, what I call sugar highs. They go and they spend the money to make themselves feel better, but they don't actually solve any problems.
But what I mean is, because like last year, he did it like right before the election.
Yeah.
Giving the stimulus
right before the recall.
Everybody.
Yeah.
Everybody, I think
$400.
That's like buying votes.
Well, it's in some countries that would be legal.
Yeah.
In California, it's just business as usual, right? And I'm distressed by what's happening.
And it's happening again.
It could happen again.
Because I think he might do it right before the election.
It could happen again.
Give you stimulus check.
Well,
just vote for me.
That's why that's why it's important. This makes it even more important for somebody to call him out. It makes it even more important that we have people in Sacramento who are willing to call out what these people are doing and saying, listen, this is not about good public policy anymore. It's not about how we make our state better. It's about raw political payoff. That's really all what it's about.
Yeah.
So we have to get tough on this kind of thing, but we can't do it unless we've got someone in a seat like controller, where the job of the controller is actually to control things, to make sure that we actually have people watching out for what's happening before these checks are cut, and then asking the right questions once the money is gone.
He did it right before the election, last election. He gave a lot of checks to small business and also the people low income stimulus check before the election.
Yeah, well, you know, like I said,
it's when you have a
single party in charge and they're able to do whatever they want, you're going to end up with some things that that look and smell awfully fishy, and unfortunately, that's what we've had here. Yes.
I can sum that up in one sentence. It's hard to run against Santa Claus. You can. It's very hard to.
It's hard to run against Santa Claus. She said. Yeah.
Yeah. Even with free money, how do you compare?
Yeah.
But we don't understand where the money's coming from. It's coming from our pocket.
Yes. Yes. Yes, sir.
Yeah, actually, we live in Santa Clara County, and it's actually nicknamed Santa Claus County. But anyway, how confident are you in terms of Kathy and I? Kathy's really the most, but we're get out the vote people. She's registered people to vote and whatever. And we're really concerned about people, you know, registering, and we're trying to get, you know, these no party preference people to think again and to register, you know, Republican, even a lot of Democrats. We've had some Democrats come up to us and said, it's time to switch parties. So the thing that scares me the most, and of course Kathy's going to say, you know, I'm really cynical, and I probably am, because I've seen, you know, the most recent, you know, where we had the recall, we were part of the groups that got signatures to get the petition to get the governor recalled on the ballot. Of course, we failed at that. That failed. The rolling back of the gasoline tax, I'm sure a lot of people are thinking that vote again. Why didn't I vote yes? I failed on that one. So what really scares me more, I mean, we can rag on our politicians, how crooked they are. What scares me the most are the voters, the supposed voters. I think that probably some people shouldn't even vote, you know, because they're not informed enough. So how confident of you? And I know you're running, so you got to say a lot of this stuff, right? You got to be confident or whatever. You got to be optimistic, but realistically, when you look at what's going on around here, and you mentioned, you know, in terms of the voter registration, you know, definitely got what three to one Democrat. So, but you also mentioned this is one thing in terms of the controller race, that this is one thing we can all kind of agree on. So how do you look at it going forward? And I'm speaking again, I guess, the other races.
Yeah.
Assembly, Senate,
yeah,
things like that.
Well, so first of all, the work of registering people and making sure they understand, you know, what it is to mean, to what does it mean when you talk about being a Republican, right? I think that work is very, very important. I'm glad that you're doing it. I'm glad that we're investing in those things. As a party, we need to be doing more of that. We need to be doing more voter registration across the state, because guess what? Our friends on the other side are doing it too, right? And so we have to be very intentional about registering voters. That's very important. One of the things that I have long believed in is that we have a set of laws in this state about, for example, you know, we've gone to an all-mail system now where everybody gets mailed a ballot. We allow a process called ballot harvesting where you can go out and basically collect a bunch of ballots. And my view is if that's the law, then let's prepare to play by the same rules. Let's up our game so that we are also doing the best we can to go out and go to areas where we know there are a lot of voters who support the principles of freedom and opportunity, and let's make sure that we're speaking to those voters and we're getting their ballots in the same way that I'm sure other entities are getting ballots for other kinds of people. So I've long argued that the Republican Party in California and those who agree with these principles should be engaging in and should be ensuring that we are competing just as well by the same rules. And it's something that I hope the party invests in. It's something that as a campaign we're going to be looking very seriously at, which is how do we put resources into making sure those ballots are actually collected legally and that they come back and that they're counted and accounted for. Because that's a very, very important concept more broadly. But this work of making sure that people understand very clearly, and the other thing that's important here is why I enjoy being able to share my vision for what I want to do is because we need to make sure we're sharing that vision directly with people. We don't need it disintermediated. We don't need other people to tell it. We don't need people to describe what we're trying to do. We need to describe it ourselves. And so we're all about getting out there, getting the message out. And so I appreciate what you're doing. And I think that if we are able to put together an effort where we're actually mobilizing voters, making sure those ballots get collected, turning them in the right way, then you know I have great confidence, actually, that we'll be able to compete in this seat. Look, it's a tough state to win in. It's a very tough state to win in, so I don't want to underestimate that. But in my race, I'm quite confident saying that I believe we will have a tremendous opportunity to convince people of all political backgrounds that it's time for accountability again.
Yes, I don't know if you're aware that in the city of San Jose, correct me if I'm wrong, they are trying to get illegals to be able to vote, right?
That's it.
They're trying to. Yep. And it's exactly. Like, that's very scary, very, very scary. So what can we do about that other than try to voice our opinion and
well,
stuff
I think,
like that?
I think that's what it is. It's you know, if you have a point of view, expressing that point of view. But, you know, elections matter. Elections have consequences. And I tell people there are all sorts of really important elections at the municipal and local levels going on. We talk about school boards. Let's take that as an example. Yeah. Think about all the stuff that's happened with school boards in this state. Heck, they recalled the San Francisco school board because those people weren't doing their jobs. Yeah. And so, you know, I talk to people all the time about, hey, you know what, running for school board's a really important thing. Because if we get this composition of these school boards right, we will have people who look out for students and parents first. And that's the job of any school board, in my view. So, I think it's about having great candidates, you know, a good message. But local elections matter a lot. What they do in San Jose matters. And so that's why these elections are so important. And making sure that we are getting out there and fielding strong candidates in all these different races is crucially important. I think I saw another hand. No, I didn't. I'm imagining. Yes, ma'am. Sure.
Go ahead.
I just want
to
get away from the speaker, otherwise you're
going to
get feedback. Yep.
Hello, Evelyn.
Hi.
Oh,
Evelyn.
I'm Peter. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Hello.
So, Evelyn's our Milpitas City Councilwoman. Awesome.
Yes. My name is Evelyn Chua, and I'm a Milpitas City Council, just like Peter Koo said. And I'm a Republican.
Yay.
How's
Yay.
That?
Only.
I just
Only
came
one.
Back from the elected official summit from Sacramento. This Friday, we had a three-day summit this week. And I was so disheartened, to be honest with you. I'm passionate about doing something about the catalytic converter thefts. Mm. So one of the sessions, I brought this up. I said, I did a lot of research, months of research, and I came across with one bill 919, which addresses the catalytic conversion, converter thefts. So I said, what happened to the bill? Because it was supposed to be discussed on April 4th. And the senators and the assembly members said, oh, it died. I said, what? that's the best of the 10 that I looked at. And I said, why did it die? Guess what? Because it was sponsored by a Republican.
Oh.
Can you imagine? I said, this is the bill that will help solve the catalytic converter taps, and they killed it. And I said, why? And so I kept pressing, and they said, oh, we'll come back with a little bit more combination of Democrats and Republican, but guess what? It's going to be authored by a Democrat. Isn't that terrible? I mean, yep. I was so disheartened, and I was like, and when I came back Friday, I kept telling everybody that will listen, I said, this is not fair. I mean, you know, we're doing something for the residents, for our people, and just because we're in a different aisle, they killed it. So that's a food for thought. And I think even with my friends who are Democrats, most of them are voting Republicans.
Yay. Good job.
So please, just go within your sphere of influence. Just, it takes one, and then one takes five, and five takes 10. So we have time, June 7th, please.
Yep.
Thank you, thank you. That's terrific, great advice, thank you, yes. No, I mean, I'll tell you, I think the enthusiasm for change is significant right now. I mean, as we look at the broader trends around my campaign and other campaigns we're talking to around the state, we are anticipating a very significant turnout amongst Republicans. But it's not just amongst Republicans. We're anticipating that there are some reform-minded Democrats who are going to vote for change. There's some independents who are going to vote for change as well. And that's the coalition we need to put together to win in this state, because I think people are frustrated. They are frustrated with what's going on. And they're looking for people who have reasonable and thoughtful solutions to the problem. And right now, I will tell you, you know, you talk about the problems we have in the state. Homelessness is a great example of this problem. I mean, we see more of it here now in Santa Clara County. In fact, I was over by the San Jose Airport the other day, and it's awful down there. $20 billion this state has spent on homelessness in 3 years. $20 billion. In the city of Los Angeles, one program, They've spent $800,000 per unit of housing construction. $800,000, they could have moved someone to Iowa, built them a house there, given them a checking account with $200,000, and they'd still have money left over. I mean, this is an example of how crazy we've gotten, where we cannot even account for the basics of how do you solve a problem. And I believe people look at that and they're fed up. And they're fed up. And so we have to give them a reasonable alternative and say, listen, there's a way out of this. There's a way out of this mess, and it starts with accountability. Any other questions before I let you all enjoy the beautiful sunshine outside? Well, I want to thank you for being here, and I just make one last plug. If you haven't voted yet, please do support me for state controller, but tell your friends, tell your family. Let's make sure that we show people that we can have accountability and change in this state. There are some lawn signs, if those of you are interested. I actually am very impressed with Milpitas, I gotta say, because I see signs all over the place. You go to some cities, it's like nobody even knows there's an election going on. But in Milpitas, you know there's an election going on. So those of you who would like to take a sign, please do. You can put it in your yard, you can put it someplace legally. Find a place that's legal, which means don't go to someone's store and just put it there without asking them first. But would appreciate folks who can spread the word. And I wanna thank you all very much for being here. And let's go out and win one. So thank you.
All right, thank you. Thank you so much, Lanhee. Really appreciate it for being here today. So again, Lanhee Chen for state controller. His name is on the ballot for every voters here in California. And so does David Fennell, running for lieutenant governor. And Bob Brunton, we appear in the city of Fremont, Milpitas, and Santa Clara.
San Jose and Newark.
Okay, so it's a new district. So last thing, I'd like to introduce my good friend Henry Yin in the back from Papa. Henry, how are you? Thanks for coming today. Again, thank you for... Henry, would you come up here and share us what's going on in Papa, would you please? Thank you. Again, by the request of Maymay, yeah. And Henry is my good friend. I mean, I got involved in politics 8 years ago, thanks to his brother, CC, and who wrote me the first check, actually. So I'm sure you brought a checker today to. No, just kidding. So Henry, please.
Yeah. Thank you, Peter. Good afternoon, Dr. Chen. Good afternoon, everyone. It's quite a pleasure to be here. And of course, Dr. Chen has been so well known. I happen to come a little bit late, sorry about this. And this is quite exciting election, because we know this position for the state of California, where I'm serving as governor-appointed commissioner for economic development for the last three governors, 11 years, and the economy definitely is one of the key for all of us, for our family. And myself, honestly, to be very happy to see Dr. Chen bring in such a wonderful qualifications and a passion. So definitely, actually, I'm on my way to Los Angeles next Thursday, and I've been arranged to meet with you again and your family. And it's one way that I've been very, very active in this community for the last 48 years, promoting civic engagement in general, and of course, particularly API. So anyway, it's my pleasure. Thank you, Peter.
Thank you.
Wish you the best, Dr.
Thank you, Henry. We appreciate it. Again, the work of Papa done in our Asian American community has been tremendous. So I thank him and his family for all he does. So we're going to spend the next 20, 30 minutes to hang out here. And for those of you who have not donated, can you tell us how?
Yes. Okay. Yeah, if you'd like to contribute to the campaign, we'd appreciate it. We've done very, very well. We've raised over almost $2.4 million, which is the most for a down ticket race like this in a very long time. But we got a lot more work to do. The best thing to do, just go to my website, Chen for California, chenforcalifornia.com, and you can contribute there, and we'd appreciate whatever you can do.
All right. Thank you so much. Okay, so enjoy some music, and Lanhee will hang on here, and then here comes our first check. Thank you so much, Victor.
All
right. Thank you. All right. Again, Bob and David will be here to talk to the voters. So if you'd like to just spend some time here, that'd be great. All right, be well.
I just killed my baby today. I'm kill your baby tomorrow. I'm telling you. Who do you think said that? You think New York is a Democrat?
Next Thursday. Have you been?
I'm in LA.
Good. Yeah,
I'm usually down there because there's more people down there. You know, so that's why I'm down there. So.
Hey, buddy.
Good to see you. How are you?
Doing well.
Yeah?
Yeah. Thanks for coming. I appreciate it.
I really enjoy your work, actually, with the institution, with the weekly
conversations. You know, the thing is with the pandemic, you know, all of these were happening virtually. I got a chance to actually.
It's awesome, right?
Oh my God, it's phenomenal. Yeah.
We've had some good conversations.
Yeah. The conversations we had with Jerry Hogan, really, really well done.
He's done some good things.
And obviously, he's out on a limb on some things. But in terms of like actually blocking a tech and running a state, not bad.
No, absolutely. I'm going to ask you, so TV ads, is that probably going to happen sometime?
We're going to call.
Okay.
We are not.
These are unopposed.
Right. We have less of a need to do that now. It would be kind of a waste of resources to do it now.
Yeah.
There are some of my opponents who are on the air.
Yeah.
You've probably seen them.
Yeah.
But they've got to compete with each other, so, you know, they'll do that and see what happens.
Yeah, no, for sure.
Yeah.
Well, best of luck
to
you.
Yeah, appreciate
my support.
Thank you.
Would you mind taking our photo?
Yeah. John, do you take a picture for us?
Sure. Okay, just a second.
Oh, even better.